to show you right now, you multiply the CPL or CPA that you got to that specific step. This is the minimum that you have to spend before you decide basically to make any changes to that step. So what you do is you take your CPC, you divide it by your conversion rate, you're getting the CPL, right? Okay, so for each step that I'm going to show you right now, you multiply the CPL or CPA that you got to that specific step. This is the minimum that you have to spend before you decide basically to make any changes to that step. Changes could be excluding it from the campaign and segmenting into another campaign, bid adjusting, killing it, whatever you decide, okay? And that's also the order of optimization. So if your CPL or CPA is, for example, $12, for each step that you see right now, you multiply the CPL or CPA according to that step, okay? So placements times 3, ads times 6, and so on, like you see, okay? So you have the minimum amount.
You don't expect the results from day one. What happens most of the time, when you set up your campaign to a CPA mode, sometimes your cost goes up. So let's say you have a conversion setting or goal of $10, and you set it to your CPA, and it goes up to $12 or $13 next day, and you're like, okay, no, this is not working. No, it does not work like that. You just reduce your CPA target to $8 and let it run for at least 2 weeks. 2 weeks, what it takes for Google AI to learn and optimize your campaign data. Don't expect anything. I mean, it can start from day one. It can do wonders from day one, but let it run for at least 2 weeks. 2 weeks is the minimum time to let Google AI to analyze your data and track it. Here is a campaign A-B testing of home security campaign which I run. Okay, on the above, you can see we got the conversion rate of about $68. And on the below, you can see on the same campaign, we were able to reduce our per cost conversion to $61.84. That's $18,200 extra net income on one campaign per month. So that's the power of CPA which you can use and utilize in your campaign.
Is something I call native search remarketing. It's just like a wide way of really pushing and really hardcore selling to that person. For example, if I'm running a mattress, online mattress site, I have my product there and I have my landing page and everything. What I like to do with the guys who didn't leave any details or didn't buy the product, I would start a search campaign on Google and I would target every one of my competitors. And of course, I would open up a different campaign for my specific brand. I would kill those people with another site. That site would be a white label site. It wouldn't have anything relating me to that product. It might be an aggregation, a top 10 sites with all of the top 10 mattresses online. And mine would be, of course, you guessed it, at the top.
The next thing you got to do is make sure that you actually turn on the targeted networks or targeting networks specifically in the shopping campaigns, all right? So when you're actually setting a campaign up, Google's going to ask you like, hey, do you want your products to show up on the search network? Do you want your products to show up on YouTube? The search network mostly is checked by default, but YouTube, if you guys don't have that checked, you want to go inside your campaigns right now, check that so you can start actually running traffic on YouTube too as well, all right?
So let's talk about how you can increase your click-through rates. Okay, some really simple hacks that work really well with YouTube. So the first thing you can do is add countdown timers at the end of your video. This will dramatically improve your click-through rate. It does it every single time. It's just a little bit of an edit at the end of your video. So the end of your video, all you're gonna wanna do is count down from 5 seconds at the end. You're doing two things. One, you're allowing the viewer to have a little bit of time to get ready to click. Because what you don't want to do is have them get to the end of the video and then just the video that you're about to watch just loads up instead. That's kind of a lost click that you could have had. And so you give them time. But the other thing is you're adding scarcity, just a natural scarcity at the end of your video. And scarcity makes people take action.
One evergreen marketing campaign. Click here and learn for free.
And then you can see the countdown timer coming in. That's exactly what it looks like. It runs, it works really well. But you may have seen in the top left-hand corner of the video, it says get ready to click. Did you see that? By adding those two things together, we had a 40% increase in click-through rate.